boy allegedly molested by Jerry Sandusky in a Penn State shower is coming forward.
You may remember his identity was a mystery during the trial. Channel 11's Rick Earle here with the voicemails the victim is now releasing. Rick.
Well, David, mystery solved. The young boy Mike McQuarrie saw being molested in the shower a decade ago has now come forward, and he released some creepy voice messages left by Sandusky just last September.
Jer, I'm probably not going to be able to get a hold of anybody. And I probably ought to just go forward. I would be very firm and express my feelings and, up front. There's nothing really to hide. So, if you want, give me a call, and they can call me on my other cell phone or on this one, either one. So, all right, take care, love you. Hope you get this message. Thanks.
Attorneys for victim 2 released that voice message they say shows that Jerry Sandusky was attempting to exert control even as his arrest was imminent last fall. And they say their client suffered extensive sexual abuse over many years, both before and after the 2001 incident witnessed by a Penn State grad assistant. Of course, that grad assistant, Mike McQuarrie, testified that he saw Sandusky sexually abusing a young boy in the Penn State showers in 2001. McQuarrie then told head coach Joe Paterno, but as we've learned, Paterno and other top administrators never reported it to authorities, and the boy never came forward until now. Attorneys for victim 2 say they plan to file a civil lawsuit against Penn State to hold them accountable for the, quote, egregious and reckless conduct that facilitated this horrific abuse. Reporting live, Rick Earle, Channel 11 News.
Meantime, there are calls for the governor to be kicked off Penn State's Board of Trustees. Who else could also be removed? That's new at 5:30. And earlier we told you about victim 2 coming forward in the Jerry Sandusky sex scandal. State Auditor General Jack Wagner is now weighing in on the scandal. He says Governor Tom Corbett and Penn State's president should not be serving as voting members on the university's Board of Trustees. He released the recommendation today as part of a review of Penn State's administration. Wagner says lawmakers need to make a move because it is impossible for university trustees to be objective in restructuring their organization.
All right, take care, love you. Hope you get this message, thanks.
Take care, I love you. A phone message allegedly from Jerry Sandusky, not to his wife, but reportedly to a newly identified victim. The phone calls were released today as victim 2 came forward and his lawyers announced intentions to sue. Victim 2 was the previously unknown boy allegedly seen showering with Sandusky. Target 11's Rick Earle brought us one of the phone messages at 5. He's back now with the second call.
Peggy, victim 2 has now come forward and he says he has the evidence to prove his case. And today he released 2 voice messages he says Sandusky left him just last fall.
I was just calling to see, I don't know whether you had any interest in going to the Penn State game this Saturday. If you could get back to me and let me know, I'd appreciate it. And when you get this message, give me a call. And I'll hope to talk to you later. Thanks. Love you.
Now, victim 2 says he suffered extensive sexual abuse at the hands of Jerry Sandusky, both before and after the 2001 assault, witnessed by a Penn State grad assistant in the football showers at Penn State University. Now, that grad assistant, Mike McQuarrie, witnessed the assault. McQuarrie was a key prosecution witness, and his testimony actually helped convict Jerry Sandusky last month. But victim 2 never came forward until now. Attorneys for victim 2 say the abuse their client and others suffered was a direct result of a conspiracy to conceal Sandusky's conduct, and they say they now plan to file a civil lawsuit against Penn State to hold them accountable. That is the very latest reporting live in the newsroom. Rick Earle, Channel 11 News.
With victim 2 coming forward today, that leaves victim 8 as the only unknown victim in the Sandusky case. He was the young boy who the janitor saw being molested in the shower in 2000.